to talk about the Gifted episode 4. Episode opens up to a flashback of the break of a breakout in the mutant detention facility. So one of the mutants was killed that was with everybody, that they were breaking somebody out, or was he? We don't know. The Mutant Underground is planning to break into the Mutant Detention Center and stop this, or not the Mutant Detention Center, but they were trying to stop this bus that was going to be coming out with Reed and Lorna. They're going to be on this bus. They're going to be transporting them. Marco goes to enlist the help of an old flame named Carmen in order to get information on the Sentinel Service's moving times. Apparently, he used to be all gooey-gooey with her. He left her for Lorna. He used to work for her father, apparently, you know, threatening people, you know, whatever business that they're doing, whatever it's drugs or whatever. The Mutant Underground is working on a plan to stop the prison truck. Lauren found a way to use her powers in connection with Andy's powers to stop the prison bus. Basically, Andy hasn't found out how to direct his powers. And with Lauren's powers, she was able to connect those powers and direct attacks or direct concussive blasts. Marcus's old flame Carmen wants him to do dirty work in order to get what he wants. So apparently in the next couple of episodes, we're going to see him going back and forth to Carmen to, I guess, pay his debt to her to do whatever it is that she's asking him to do. I just love The Gifted, man. I absolutely love this show. It just gets better week after week. Blink is still having these dreams and emotions about Johnny that were giving to her from the mutant who could give emotions and dreams. Lauren and Andy were able to stop the bus, and Sentinel Services started to move into position to be in defense because they knew something wasn't right. Apparently, Sentinel Services is using that mutant that we thought got killed. His name is Pulse. He has the ability to stop automatic weapons and systems, and apparently he has the ability to stop mutant powers as well. So, again, he's being used by Sentinel Services. The Sentinel Services got ready to move Reed and Lorna, and they attacked, but were easily stopped. Johnny ended up having to take Pulse out so they could continue to move forward with their plan. Once they did that, Lorna's powers were back. Everybody's powers were back to full force. Lorna didn't have any metal around her because they had a bit up. The inside of the bus had plastic, damp plastic, so she wasn't able to move, kind of just like how they did Magneto in, what was that, the first X-Men or the second X-Men, kind of just like they did him there. Reed said, hey, take the screw out of my leg. Apparently, he had leg surgery a while back. She was able to take that screw out, and she did. Damn it. She went to work and was able to get everybody out. Everybody got free. Everybody got away. Reed got reunited with Caitlin. The kids, of course, were already gone. And now everybody's headed back to the Mutant Underground, and Detective Jace is not happy. He said, hey, send everybody after them. We're going to find them. Go to anybody that has any connections with them. We got to stop them from continuing to move forward with this. So what did you think about this episode? I truly enjoyed it. I enjoy watching The Gifted each and every single week. I want to know what you think about it. Let me know in the comments below, whether you're watching this on Facebook or if you're watching this on YouTube. You guys have a good one. We'll see you guys next week.